10 episodes. 10 episodes of this shit. What are you still doing here? What are we still doing here? What is the meaning of life? Whatever. Welcome to the special anniversary episode of Council of Reeds. Yes, anniversary. Marvel.
Call that an anniversary.
Marvel rules, bro. If it's divisible by 5 or 10, it's anniversary. Let's put a $5.99 price tag on it.
Nah, that's gonna be issue 12. Issue 12 and 25.
No.
What do you mean 12 and 25?
That's how it should be.
You need Daniels.
It used to be always, anniversary would be like a 12 parter, a 12 issue,
and
issue
goes, 25. And it goes for both numbers as well.
50.
Because
jump.
Marvel's got two numbers. And they,
Legacy.
They go for both.
That's true.
Yes.
So how long till we're number one again? Because that won't take long if it's...
Next week.
Reboot.
Relaunch.
We swap seats.
I'm Dylan. I'm here with Jason.
Yep.
Nitin.
Yep.
Fommy.
Hey.
And Dave.
42 is your answer.
Nice.
Okay, so this week Marvel had a Justice League comic book.
They did, and it was pretty good.
It was awesome. We have that to talk about. We also have a pile of exciting new action figures.
Yes.
Including Shang-Chi.
Yes.
And Jonathan Hickman X-Men. Mm. And we're going to be talking about the Phase 4 teaser trailer thing for MCU. Bad Batch, Jupiter's Legacy, and our film flashback segment for this week, Spawn.
Film.
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 Film. Film. Alrighty.
All right.
Let's go.
Heroes Reborn.
Heroes Reborn.
Very good. Okay. So it's obviously spins out of the Jason Aaron Avengers run, which, when that first started, I really dug it. Yes, yes, that's why I said that first. I don't know, because I haven't even read the last, I have to finish the last arc and I skipped to this. And so out of the Jason, which I loved at first. Because at first it was all Squadron and the Vampires, so much cool. But the last couple of arcs have been a bit eh for me anyway. But this, really back on track. Basically, it's the Avengers don't exist. So something's happened. We don't know what's happened. But Blade is the only one that remembers. So Blade, who has been in the Avengers in this series. You don't know that part?
It's on the cover or something.
But yeah, he's the only one that remembers. And then, but the Squadron Supreme, the premier super team of America, and then you got some supervillain mashups. That were pretty fun. I thought it was good.
That's nice.
Best beginners I've seen in a long time. I've always been a fan, but I really liked this.
I'm a big fan.
Like that double page spread where you get the each of them. So nice.
I can't wait for the one shots and stuff.
Yeah,
because it just looks really interesting.
Yeah, the world that they're building.
Yeah.
So this, are they from their own dimension or are they?
No.
Something's happened
main
to
Marvel
warp
universe.
This one.
Right.
I'm pretty sure. I got some ideas, but I don't want to spoil things for people.
Well, the trading, the little promotional trading cards that came with. You got a pack of it?
Yes.
Yeah. Kind of style like the old 90s Marvel cards. The first appearances for the Squadron characters are like 2019. You see that or something?
Yeah, but this one's open.
Yeah, look at the first appearance for the...
Where's first appearance?
Huh.
I can't read these. Where's first appearance?
First appearance, Avengers number 10, November 2018.
Yes! So
well,
is this like
a different...
A new version of
the
Squadron?
Because it's not like... It's not the Hyperion from, say, Hickman Avengers.
No.
You know what I mean? Clearly not. Like, just in... When you've... Because you would agree, right? You've read some Squadron issues, yes? It's not... Yeah. I think it's more akin to the classic... pre-Straczynski revamp versions, I feel.
Oh, okay.
You know, because when Straczynski did the Max Supreme Power stuff to modernise them and go the full mature. And then, like, the Hyperion was a bit more like that one. But this is classic versions.
Cool.
You know, like, proper 80s Heroes versions. Simple. That was really good.
Can you remember those ones? Are they all the same cards?
No.
Collect a set.
They're kind of a set.
They're the same cards.
I was going to say, each pack is the same, is it not?
Yeah.
Sorry, I thought you meant if the... Yeah.
You will just lie. Jeez. Freak me out.
Did you buy it, didn't
did you?
Dr. Know? Juggernaut.
Yeah. Dr. Juggernaut, man!
Yeah, so it looks nice.
The Squadron are the best heroes on Earth, but the main villains are the Masters of Doom instead of the Master of Evil, and it's Dr. Doom, and he's got the Sidorok gem, so he's Dr. Juggernaut.
Yeah. And there's this other really cool one that I don't want to mention.
Yeah, you might.
Yeah, we're not. We can't get it.
Yeah.
But it's so cool.
Yeah.
Catching up.
Yeah, I thought it was a really fun issue. Like
these guys look like they join up.
Yeah, they do the some background. Of them. They do, some of them do.
So,
go on by the variants, I think, because the cards are also variants, trading, you know, back yeah, back trading card variant. And I think one, it says middle, right, left, or whatever, so yeah, some...
It'll be like a
picture, yes.
Oh yeah, it's a collage.
Like the
yeah,
old days of cards?
Yeah.
For sure, for sure.
So, it says superhero, supervillain on these cards. Is that
yes,
a spoiler or not really?
I don't think so. Spoiler. Yes, I think it's the main middle obvious, you know?
Especially the, I don't know.
Oh, right.
I think I know what you mean. We're
yeah,
that.
That one.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
That was cool. Where Blade goes, sees him.
Yeah.
Sees the big guy sort of thing.
Okay.
I'll probably buy that issue, but I don't know if I'll continue.
So, like, basically, without giving away too much, yeah, like, Avengers never happened, so all the classic Avenger guys are either, yeah, alright, it's not a spoiler, no one's gonna care. Stark's still just a drunk arms dealer, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. The shrapnel never happened.
Never learned his lesson and
stuff like that, so, yeah. Like, Doctor Strange's place is just a head shop.
Would he still but would he, is he a surgeon?
Well, you don't see.
Right.
He's not prevalent because he's not in the...
Yeah. That'd be cool if he was like a mob doctor.
Yeah, he would be just a doctor for sure.
A mob doctor. How cool would that be?
Yeah, most likely that hasn't happened.
Or just a nurse.
But I thought it was really good.
It was solid.
Fun.
Just a nurse.
It did look so good.
Yeah. Oh, man.
No offense, nurses. You do a great job.
yeah, I'm super keen. It's a weekly. Issue 2 is this coming week. So, and plus two of the first...
5 or 6 parts.
5 parts, I think. And then, like, a few one-shots. Like,
and then Heroes Return
yes,
is the finale.
Yes.
McGinnis drawing the whole thing?
The main mini, yes.
Oh, in a weekly book, so that's all you can then.
Yeah, oh, for sure.
Says
well, he hasn't done much.
To see on the cards, though. Oh, cover.
Well, there's a lot of different ones. So.
Because, yeah, there's, like, this week coming out, we also got the Legion issue and the Jimmy Olsen issue.
Can't wait for them!
And so, yeah. Ah, it's good. It's
that
fun.
Was really good. Yes.
All right, what else we got? Actually, what about Enter the Robin?
Enter the Robin. Issue 1 of Damien's new series.
Everyone's favourite.
Where he goes to an island along with the world's deadliest fighters to compete in a tournament.
Sounds familiar.
Yes!
Oh. Seen a few things like that.
Yeah.
In my day. Because basically he's got out of town because he's... After everything that happened with the Batman, Bane, City of Bane arc, and then the Joker War, and killing off Alfred... Spoilers. that was like 6 months ago, bro. Come on. He's done a runner sort of thing. You know, Bruce and the Bat family are looking for him, but he's out there trying to find the... What is it called? The Lazarus something?
The League
of
Lazarus. That's what the tournament's called.
Every 100 years they have the best fighters have a tournament.
And they fight to the death.
Yes.
Is it in Rajal Ghul? Revolt?
No, like obviously there's going to be a connection. Well, because the island is Lazarus Island, I think.
Yeah.
So, and like, yeah, obviously there's going to be something because, man, the end you're like, oh, crap. Because he's still, they've aged him up a little, yeah? Because he used to be 12, he's like 14 now.
Oh, is he? I must have missed that.
Okay.
Yeah, he's 14 in this.
Oh, okay.
Well, he used to be 12, yeah?
No, he was 13,
okay.
I believe, yeah.
Because I mentioned him being 14. And he seems a little more mature, but still... Still cocky.
Yes.
Still...
He's written great. He's just the biggest prick.
Yeah.
Like...
Yeah. I really like the issue, actually.
Yeah, I liked it too. I don't like the art.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good.
Yeah.
So good.
I haven't seen this guy.
Clean.
Looks like Todd Knock.
Yeah. Well, because he draws good kids. No, Todd Knock draws the best kids in comics. Because they don't just look like short people.
Mm-hmm.
I hate a guy where they drew a teen book and they're just midgets. Like, nothing wrong with being a midget, but... that's not what a kid is. Like, they're proportioned. You can't just draw them small. They've got to be proportioned like a kid.
Jason meant to say little people for everyone out there.
Have you seen my height? I'd get away with it. And that voice? Part of the Lollipop Guild. Come on.
Oh, yeah. You're talking about the character shows up. His name's Respawn.
Yes.
And he's straight up just like Deathstroke.
Yes.
Right. And then Robin's like... Hey, nice copyright infringement.
Nice. Should have been gimmick infringement. Would have been the best. Yeah, it was good. I liked it.
It was awesome.
I do like Damien.
I've grown to
really
like
fun.
Him a lot more.
Yeah, same. Because
he's different. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, he's not
yeah.
just nice like everybody else.
He's got
just...
such a chip on his shoulder. As you would, right?
Mm-hmm.
Your mum's Talia. Your dad's Batman.
You were trained since childbirth to be a...
You gotta back yourself.
Does
and he does.
Different mindset to most people that age.
Yes.
And he killed people, right?
Yeah. So he's not afraid of anything. The new costume redesign was pretty nice.
I would like some more. I don't know. It is a bit dull.
I think, though, because he's trying to be...
But that's the point.
Undercover-ish. Yeah. Not undercover, but... Like, they don't know... Not everyone knows who he is at first. Yeah, it was good. I liked it. I liked it.
You did have some neat cameos in there, too.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Yes, what else you read?
I read Batman Superman.
Oh, yes.
So that's part two of this...
The serial.
Yeah, the serial kind of arc. And that was awesome.
Oh, man, it's good.
Yeah.
The... I thought about you, Dave, when I was reading it with the Mojo ripoff guy.
Yes.
So that's what's going on. Some dude's filling with stuff, but it was good. Like the art. I know we're just talking about art so much, but
Ivan
Reese.
It is perfect.
He does some of the best comic art going around.
It is perfect.
So in this last issue, we had the two timelines going, and then Lois fell through Superman's into Batman's world. This one, Superman flows through, so they meet, sort of thing, and then. They realise they're from different places, not to get too much spoilers for people, but I thought it was really good.
They were all written great.
Mm. Yeah.
Like Batman's first instinct, he doesn't know who Superman
is,
but his first
instinct
is, I'm going to try and kill that guy.
Yeah.
And Lois is like, no, don't hurt him. He's like, oh, whatever, I'll try and blow him up.
And like, there's no Superman in Batman's world, obviously, so like Metropolis is a hellhole because there's no Superman and stuff. And that was good, it was good. Yeah, I pleasantly surprised how good this has been. Because the guy did a good job on Smashes the Clan.
Yes.
So I knew he can do a good Superman, but the idea... They didn't give you much in this list except for, oh, cool, it's like the 40s versions.
Yes.
And you're like, oh, how's this going to work? But good, good, good. I dig it.
It is very Mojo-y.
Yeah. But,
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah, it was solid. Yeah. Just more of what he started in that last issue.
Yeah. For sure.
So that last, what issue number is this?
Two. Part two,
but it's issue 17.
But wasn't 16 like a different issue to this? I'm thinking something else, aren't I?
I don't know.
Yeah. No, 15 was totally different.
It was pre-future state?
Yeah. anyway.
Yes. Why they didn't reboot it, I don't know, but...
It's like
we
spoke
about that when it first came out. So,
yeah.
And at the same time, there was a few books that were also getting rebooted at the time. So like, this is the perfect time to do that, but they didn't.
Yeah, some of them
desperately
needed
Dave's confused.
One.
So thanks, DC. You've confused Dave.
That's not hard.
Poor Dave.
So good, Dave.
Yes.
Part two. Don't ignore that 17.
Yeah.
Just write two in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll get some Texas for you.
No,
you can do it to all of them.
Yeah, Spider Lady stuff. Oh, that's some good stuff.
Man, those messed up versions of Joker and
Batman.
Yeah,
did you see that?
Mouths.
Yeah,
that was intriguing.
That was, you're like, what the hell?
Yeah, so they're clearly from other film.
Yes. Oh,
reels, right?
I don't know. Because, it's not like these 40s versions are like the old. They're obviously like. Universe 3, 4, whatever, they're not just the past of DC proper.
Because Batman and Robin were they don't look like the Joker and...
Yeah, that we just fought last night or whatever, right? Yeah. Yeah, it's... I'm not exactly sure what's going on sometimes, but in a good way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because you need some of that.
Yeah, for sure.
To kind of string you along.
Yeah. Alright, what's next? I checked out Marjorie Finnegan, Temporal Criminal, the new Garth Ennis book. I'm always trying a new Ennis book.
Yes.
So it's this chick, Marge. She's a time criminal. So it starts off, she's back in like ancient Egypt and trying to steal stuff and getting into fights. And it's usual Ennis-y. It's pretty mundane for Ennis, but her mouth's definitely Ennis-y, shall we say. It was fun, but... No, it didn't wow me, but I'm intrigued enough to try issue two. Because then you got her, that's the main story, her, she's out back in Egypt and whatever. And then all of a sudden it cuts to, the B story, and it's this Nazi dude selling, villagers artillery so they can defend themselves against the Vikings that are about to come.
Okay.
And, it just jumps from the ancient Egypt to this, and you're like, what's going on here? And then,
But she's there as well.
Hey?
So, but she's in that story...
Not exactly.
Okay.
It's a different chick. Because she got an eye patch.
Of course. Stupid.
I did the same thing.
How dare
I was confused.
I am also just flicking, not reading, but
yeah,
that's...
So, the Nazi gets beat by... time cop, I guess. If the main chick's the criminal, the other one's the time sheriff. It's just, it's weird. Like, it wasn't the most NSC, but I can see it will get way more over the top. Yeah. It was fun.
Wow.
I dig it. I dig it. I'm a sucker for his stuff. He just does some bent stuff.
Yeah, he's the best.
Yeah.
He's
so bent.
I didn't even realize this was coming out.
Yeah. But if you like Garth Ennis,
wow.
It ain't Preacher or Boys level of good at first issue, but yeah, a lot of potential.
Definitely
there.
Definitely different.
And at the end, where like the two sort of A and B stories sort of meet, you're like, oh crap, now okay. I get it.
Oh, that's really cool.
I'll tell you off screen experience, I don't spoil for
yeah.
You.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, you see?
I just saw it.
Yeah, and you're like, oh, okay, I get it.
A part A.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I thought you might do that, Ninton. That was good,
They're really pumping stuff out, aren't they?
AWA.
Yeah.
Yeah. Killing it. I think they're wrestlers or something. What else, Dylan? What do you read? What else you want to talk about? What do you got?
Crime Syndicate really picked up in this issue, I believe.
I've got to catch up on this.
Because it's kind of like the finale with Starro, and you find out that Starro is just trying to run away from the Green Lanterns.
Cool.
The Green Lanterns are just trying to murder it, and Starro's like, come to Earth looking for help.
Yep.
And the Starro's like, help, everybody, you know, help me.
Okay, people don't know, the Crime Syndicate, bad versions of the Justice League.
Yes.
So the villains are usually the good guys.
Yes.
So Starro is getting attacked by the bad guys.
Yes.
Instead of the other way around, right?
Comes to Earth, and then the Crime Syndicate is like, the hell are you doing here? You're trying to take over the planet? Nah.
Done.
Smack him. And then he's like, the whole issue, he's like pleading for his life. It's kind of sad, actually. But, yeah, it answered the question that we all had, like, are they going to go into the supervillains being superheroes kind of thing? Yeah. And
you got to. It's the only way for it to work, right?
And Lex Luthor makes an appearance as well.
Ooh.
And the whole issue, he's like, what are you guys doing? We need to evacuate the city. And then the Crime Syndicate is just like, nah, we'll just fight the guy. Don't worry. The city gets wrecked.
Cool.
It's great. It really picked up.
Yeah, I didn't read that.
I'm kind of sad it's only 6 issues, though. But yeah, I'll definitely be reading the rest.
Cool.
And you can see on the cover, there's like some flipped versions of some DC characters.
Yeah.
See like Dr. Fate on there.
Anything with Dr. Fate always gets my attention. Because you don't get enough Dr. Fate.
No, he's a great character.
So cool looking.
He was a big part of Justice League Dark, the recent one.
Yeah.
Like both Kent Nelson and... what was the other kid's name? Oh, I forgot the kid's name.
Yeah.
But the kid. Yeah. They were both in it. They were great.
Good stuff. I also read last night Star Wars War of the Bounty Hunters Alpha, which is big Star Wars crossover. Probably the biggest crossover since Marvel's took over, really.
They haven't really done
major.
We had
Vader down, and that was about it at the start. That was 2 titles. This is multiple titles. Boba Fett-centric. This issue was just Boba Fett. It is set just after Empire. So Boba's just loaded up handing carbonite, but the carbonite is coming apart. And so he has to stop somewhere to try to get some help get fixed up. And then, adventures ensue.
It's so pretty.
The structure and what happens in it reminds me of an episode of Mando.
Oh, big time.
You know, it feels like an episode
of
Mando.
Big time. That was the vibe,
Yeah, like
right?
He's on his way somewhere and something goes wrong and he has to go there and make some money. And
just need some pan whistles in the background.
Man, when I was reading it, I could hear Mando's voice every time Boba speaks, you know what I mean? Like, that's how...
Just looking at it now, you can hear the...
Yeah, it was, very Mando.
That's, really cool.
And McNiven!
Yeah, man.
McNiven on the
armor. Oh, hello. So beautiful.
Yes.
Some nice armor.
Yes.
Wow.
It looks beautiful.
Yeah. But yeah.
Oh, wow. Very pretty book.
I hadn't read a Star Wars book for a while. First of all, I was doing buying everything. And there's got to be Star Wars fatigue. And I lent off a few of them, but this is
so what
good.
Is this going to be an ongoing or a
crossover between like Star Wars and Bounty Hunter and Vader as well, maybe?
I'm not sure.
It's a few of the Star Wars titles, maybe all the Star Wars titles actually. I guess there'll be a checklist at the back. I think Dave can have it for us because
that is Alpha.
Yeah,
so. You got it, Dave?
Oh yeah, so Star Wars, Bounty Hunters, Darth Vader, Dr. Aphra,
got all of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a lot of books.
Yeah, yes. That's why I will I think I'll buy the trade.
So that's the reason I was asking.
Yeah.
Lom and Zuckus.
There's a lot of...
Yeah.
Because all the bounty hunters are going to be in it, supposedly.
It's like they're all racing to get Solo,
yeah.
I suppose. Like,
yeah.
Are they all
going to
be on the island? And...
Pretty much.
Well,
they could
fight.
Yeah.
That's an idea.
Well, there's arena gladiator fights in this. That was cool, I thought.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
The way they set that up. The
and
whole
familiar species as well.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hmm.
But yeah, Star Wars people, check it out.
Yeah.
It's very good.
It's one of the prettiest Star Wars books.
Ah, so good, so good, so good, so good.
McNiven, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He doesn't do enough these days.
No,
he's very slow.
I think his stuff has changed a lot over the years. And this might be his best, like, I don't know. Because he's getting more detailed, I feel.
What was it, a backup we saw the other week that he did? Like a Batman backup or something?
There was something recently.
Yeah.
But like, because you look at that and then you think of, like, I think of Civil War.
Mm-hmm.
And this is so much more detailed than Civil War or Old Man Logan era stuff.
Oh, sure.
But, like, you know, still McNiven,
yeah.
And that was always nice, but he's putting more line work in, I feel.
Yeah, it's...
yeah, very nice, very nice.
So does it just stop... That's still him, right?
No.
No, it's just before that, right? Where it's...
Well,
I don't...
McNiven.
Yeah,
the whole book?
The whole book.
Oh, the whole book, okay.
Yep. What else you got? Grinlin?
Grinlin!
How was that? I have not read that, no.
It was really cool. It was continuing with...
There was a pretty big thing that happened in the last of the book, wasn't there?
The last one?
Yeah.
It's dealing with the fallout of that.
Yep.
The way this one ended, I'm not too sure.
Sure.
It's kind of something that's happened before.
Sure.
Yeah, I won't go into
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but usual sort of Grinlin-y stuff?
Yes.
Like, I think I know what you mean. Like,
yes.
Oh, no.
Yes, oh no, something bad has happened.
Yeah.
That has happened quite a couple times.
Yeah.
And I just...
I think that's most of the lesson.
Yes, seriously. But the ride was good. It was written well.
Still a lot of... Because the first show, what I really liked is the politics side of it.
There is
it
more
very,
of that.
Yeah, cool. Because the first one was just like watching episode one.
Yes.
I really love it. How's the Far Sector chick?
She... Not in it that much.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So I just seen she was on the van, so I assume she must be in more. Just like, I guess, the Teen Lantern was
so
a lot.
This does deal with their restructuring and what exactly the Lanterns are going to be doing. And
cool.
Some of them are like, oh, we have to concede some of our territory.
Yep.
So because the United Planets has their own peacekeeping force, so we got to give some of the territory to them. And that means restructuring.
Sure.
So heaps more.
So I do like to find that they're finally going to be a official police force, not just rocking to town like...
Yes.
The sheriff arm running his joint. This is it. But yeah, good. I got to catch up.
Curious to see where it goes, because so far I'm just like, this happened before.
Yeah.
I
how
just want
pretty
to
is it? But
it looks great.
DC, I mean, across the board, their art is killing it these days. Their fancy, nice paper does help a lot too, and they're just colours. I think they've got the best colourist in comics at the moment. They're all very colourful and vibrant. Where Marvel can... Like, they've got more consistent look about their art these days. Where Marvel... Like, some books look great and some books not so great.
Because like that first issue, you got two artists. You got Dexter Soy and you got, I think, Santucci.
Hmm.
And they're both... Yeah. Doing their own bits in the story. They both are really good.
Hmm.
It's a weird critique, but... Because pretty much all I read is Marvel books. And when I do have a flick, you can notice the paper difference.
Oh, yeah.
It's better.
It is a weird critique, but it's so true.
Yeah.
Watch them change it in 3 weeks.
They've stuck with this for a while,
yeah.
So I hope it stays.
And more books got it. Like, at first, they tried on a few books to see what the response was. So I don't know if I would assume it's probably a cheaper option, you would think. I would doubt they're spending more than they have to. But yeah, it's good. I like it. The only other thing I read was Noctera, issue 3. This is moving along nicely. We get a bit more stuff, but not much to go into. I don't want, it's just continuation of what's been going, but I'm enjoying that. More and more, actually, I think, because there's less and less dialogue, less and less writing, so that helps. And Tony Daniel just looks pretty.
Can't go wrong with
we get more. We get a little bit more info on the Shade Monster people thing and how they turn and when it's too far. Because, like, the brother's on his way, right? That's in the first couple of issues, the brother's... A little infected, for lack of a better word. You explain where, like, you get a thing where they cut off, and by the end, you're like, oh, look out, I think you're in trouble here. Yeah, it's good, good. I really like it.
I was wondering if you'd go straight to that.
Yeah, it's good. What about you? You got anything else?
Last thing I read was Action Comics. That's the first part of a new story.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Ooh. So this is...
Who is he?
The Mongol stuff. He's good! I think he was on...
Sanfury.
I think he was on Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah,
yeah. So I wasn't sure about picking this up, and then I opened it.
Very nice.
I opened it, and I was like, okay, I've got to read this.
Yeah,
it looks fantastic. The art the whole way through, okay. Incredible.
Yeah, not bad, eh?
Yeah. And it's Philip Kennedy Johnson, and like his Superman stuff in that first two-part arc that he did through Superman and Action, it's all about Superman and John's relationship.
Sure.
And you know, at the beginning, Superman's doing some tests with Batman and Adam, and they're seeing that he's not as strong, he's not as fast as he used to be, and Batman's like afraid that he's, you know, he's getting weaker and he's gonna
eventually
die. Maybe he's got radiation poisoning. And obviously Adam's like, no, don't be so morbid. You know? And then Superman's like, no, it's alright, let's just tell he's...
Which Adam?
Ryan Choi, I believe.
Yeah, I assume so.
Yeah. I think so, actually. I didn't really pay attention to that. But I'm pretty sure it's him.
Cool.
But it was great. Real solid.
Interesting.
Well, I guess this gives you more of a hint of where things go. Because that two-parter being both on Superman Action, and then we find out Superman's finishing. So this is obviously where the main story is going to go, right?
And it ends on a
big thing?
Fairly big thing. Mm-hmm. Again, nothing that hasn't kind of happened before, but interesting nonetheless.
That'd be one pager of Supes flying just above the water.
It's great!
Yeah. Yeah.
It's
pretty.
It's filled with great art. And the next page, he's like fighting this giant robot.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Look at all these good DC books you should be buying in.
It is great.
Missing out, didn't
you? Damien is in this for a bit, and he's chilling with John.
Cool.
And they're sitting there and they're eating. My one nitpick about that is he's too nice.
Yeah, sure.
Damien,
he
doesn't sound like Damien.
Yeah, yeah, got you. I think he would be harder to write. Oh,
100%.
Because, to get his attitude right, but not make him unlikable, you got to get that level of knobness right. Essentially. Anybody else do any reading? Vums, where are we up to?
September. I had to go away for work this week, so I didn't get to read a huge amount, but I got to finish a couple more books into House and Powers of X,
which
is good. That's just, I think I've got like 5 and 6 of each left to read. Finished Absolute Carnage. That was like absolute carnage. A lot of death, a lot of destruction, a lot of spines getting ripped out.
What about when we get like the Hulk?
End of issue 3.
Hulk venomized.
Because the Hulk had never been venomized previously. That was quite cool.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised.
Yeah,
because it seems like a genius idea.
Oh, because Red Hulk's gotten it before.
Yes.
Yeah, I remember reading that.
Yes, because he was found in a pile of bodies. That was quite interesting. That was an interesting. That Immortal Hulk tie. All the tie-ins were quite good. There's a couple of. The Morales one wasn't great, but yeah, the Immortal Hulk one was good. Even like the Lethal Protectors ones, because it showed all other like Hybrid and all those come back. But then it also there was good Misty Knight and Moon Knight and Iron Fist. And Jameson.
Yeah, the Jameson stuff I really dug.
Jameson is the Carnage Werewolf by Night was very interesting.
Yeah.
John Jameson.
But trying to protect Misty, but like fighting the symbiote at the same time.
Okay.
But then it was also a good one with, it was Cloak and Dagger, Morbius, Moon Knight, and Iron Fist from Maximum Carnage, because they got together and helped, you know, City Streets and stuff back in that series, so getting them back together again was really good. So that worked out well. Venom, I think it moves on to Venom Island next.
Yep.
So they're going on to an island.
Yep. Just gotta go to an island.
What else? I think that was about it.
Yeah.
I think there's a couple other, just other books that I need to now catch, because they essentially read that event, so I just got to go back and catch up on other tie-ins, and not tie-ins, but everything else besides the tie-ins from those
months. Back up to date.
So that was really, really good, and I'm pumped for, I might even just start reading, I've got the trade sitting there, so I might just get to read forward into Venom and try and smash into King of Black.
For sure.
Yeah.
Cool.
Speaking of Maximum Carnage, It's too big to pull out and show you. Probably see the Carnage statue. Oh, Marvel oh. Fine Arts, Maximum Carnage. Oh,
I'll oh. magic a picture in there for
oh,
you, YouTube
God.
Viewers.
God. When I put it together, like, I didn't even put all the extra bits in because it's too big. And I had to move the shelf. It's so huge.
Massive base, right?
Yeah.
It's like 60% base.
Yeah.
And then the Carnage is also
big, but like
pretty
yeah.
sizable. And then there's like 10
of tentacles. And
10 tentacles. That's no exaggeration. There's like 10 tentacles coming out of it.
I'm like, they're staying in the box.
Yeah, because that'll... Yeah.
Or just less things to...
Break.
Yeah. Well, I was like, I'm going to know him whether I was going to even put his arm on. I was like, that might look a bit too weird. Yeah, that's great.
It's
statue.
Great.
What about you two? You reading?
Nope.
Terrible.
Alrighty. Let's get into new toys for this week.
New toys?
Because
yeah.
we actually got quite a lot.
Alright, since Fomi's been catching up on his House and Powers, we got the new Marvel Legends X-Men based on essentially the House and Powers arc.
Nice.
Sentinel chick.
Oh, yep.
Cyclops.
Pro tip. You see how it's in... ineligible
Marvel Girl.
Mutant language?
Yes.
On the kind of
that's
side
the character's
there.
Name?
On the side there. It's
that's
got
it.
English.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's the...
We got Wolverine. Magneto in white. Moira McTaggart. I've never been so excited about just a person
yeah,
figure ever.
Yeah, I looked at her for a long time.
Yeah.
Oh.
And sexy Xavier with his helmet.
Yeah, seriously.
That helmet's excellent.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I'm talking about how he's, like, hot.
Yeah. Sexy Xavier. And the builder figure is the Tri-Sentinel, which is pretty cool looking.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
yeah, like it's a weird looking Sentinel, eh?
Was
it's
that,
a different looking figure.
Was that in the...
I think so. Isn't that sort of in the future stuff?
Yeah, I think it was in the Powers book.
Yeah, Power stuff, I think.
They should have all
yes,
the
is.
Things, though.
That Cyclops Eye Blast looks excellent.
Yeah, the effects.
Yeah.
Yeah. The effects are some of the best things that's happened the last maybe. Few years of Legends.
Oh, yeah.
Like, yeah. You know, like, the first start doing it would be like... strange, and he'd have like woo things around his hand. And you're like, but they've gotten so much better. The Cyclops optic blast is the best stuff.
That powers I just read it was the where they're trying to destroy the mother mold.
Oh
yes,
yes!
And Nightcrawler bamps him and Wolverine, and as he bamps out, he just gets annihilated, and then Wolvie's there. Oh yeah,
yeah,
that was mental.
Yeah,
so
that was crazy.
Oh okay, yeah, with the Cyclops.
And then we've got also some Marvel Legends, some
Shang-Chi,
and Iron Man. AI Iron Man from a couple of years ago for no extra reason. He looks cool.
Looks excellent.
Spoilers, it's going to be in the show, in the movie.
Might be.
Spoilers.
Big spoilers. yeah, the bad guy.
Oh, yes, how are you going to read that, Jason?
It's the lady, a friend, I think.
Charlene.
Charlene.
I
Charlene.
Can't say any of these names, man. I barely got Tony Stark out properly.
This one's Death Dealer.
Tony
Death Dealer.
This is
Death
his dad.
Dealer. Not French. Not Frazetta's dad.
Yeah.
Death Dealer.
His dad. And this is
Wenwu.
And this is Kim's Convenience Boy.
Shang-Chi. You can't see.
Kim Convenience Boy. What's his name? Kim's Convenience.
Oh,
Shang-Chi.
I haven't watched it.
It's a good show.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
For a sitcom, really good. I liked it a lot.
That Iron Man looks really cool, just as a normal Iron Man.
Yeah.
Right? Because he's got the head.
Yes.
Just
yeah.
real bright. He just looks like a toy.
Yeah. Because it's the 80th anniversary Iron Man.
Yeah.
Just,
and before that,
just,
I think...
recolored a bit.
I think that 80th...
But this coloring is better.
I think that 80th anniversary, that was an old mold already.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah,
it looks
great.
You put
the helmet on, that's the perfect Iron Man figure for me.
Yes.
Oh, and the build-up in this. Mr. Hyde. Did you check out the build-up on the back? Oh.
The body is massive.
Though. Yeah. Look at that. Look at that. Dylan will find real pictures. And
yes, I will.
It looks very cool.
Oh, yeah. Shailene's got like this rope dart.
The detail on these has just gone... It's just scary.
Yeah.
The
likenesses. Like,
I can't believe the likenesses.
Yeah, sometimes they get on a different, a certain angle. You're like, oh, that's a little off, but still unbelievable.
And the printing on the faces is so
like
precise.
Civil Warrior.
Oh, yeah, Civil Warrior. That's another figure in the wave.
Ah, oh,
that is from the Contest of Champions mobile game.
Okay.
And it's essentially
just pat out.
Captain America in, like, an Iron Man suit.
Yeah.
And his shield's got an arc reactor on it. Like, he looks cool.
But you need to get him to get the head.
Yeah. Oh, my God, do you really?
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course. Smart move.
That's the best.
Speaking of figures this week, we also got the Bill and Ted Bogus Journey figures.
They look cool
with the classic X card style, and the Excellent Adventure phone booth.
Looks so cool.
That lights up, doesn't it, the phone booth?
I think
so. I better do something.
It's a good price, Dave.
Bargain, Dave.
Now, these look pretty cool.
Yeah, they're good. They're like they're a little pricey, but
yeah.
They're a small toy company.
Oh,
you know what I mean? It's not like it's Hasbro or Mattel.
Oh, you get the blister box is grooved.
Yes, they're weird, eh?
Yeah,
I never ever
yeah,
had
like
a bubble
it,
like that.
Yeah, it's like it's reversed.
Yes,
it's so hard to price up too.
Yeah,
you got to find the right spot.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to put the price tag on the card.
Yeah.
Just
and
in
you
case.
Don't cover his face, but you sort of have to, because
yes.
That's the flat bit. Right?
Yes.
You get
closed
a,
in the dark.
Just for everyone, it includes a guitar, a strumming hand, and the Evil Us hand.
Yes.
Yes.
Excellent.
But isn't that just tempting to make you buy two sets?
Yeah. I want Station.
Yes. Or you need a... Station is singles,
yeah,
and then a double
yeah.
Deluxe,
oh, yes.
Right?
Yep.
Ah. I think Death they're doing for sure.
Mm-hmm.
He might
you
be exclusive of some kind. Maybe a kind of exclusive I thought I seen. But that'd be pretty cool. Because they did Excellent Adventure ones before. That's why the phone booth come out for that. We need a Rufus too, though.
Yes. That was my
discussion. Now with the phone booth.
And his pictures there.
Yeah. So, I just love the X cards.
Yeah.
All
right. That is pretty great.
Toby's X-Men. That's a toy to me. I think that was about all the merch.
Yes, it was. Alrighty. We'll get into the Marvel Phase 4 teaser.
Oh yeah, I just watched that. I haven't watched that yet.
So, it was mostly...
old footage.
Yeah, mostly old footage. We knew the existence of these movies. Some of them have had title changes though. So, stuff like The Marvels.
Yeah,
that was originally...
which is the Captain Marvel 2,
yes.
Basically, right?
And Black Panther, of course. Black Panther, Wakanda Forever.
Mm.
Was Ant-Man and what's called Quantumania...
Yes.
Originally,
I think
okay.
So. Yeah.
It was Quantum something. I don't
okay.
know if it was Quantum Mania.
I think
it
was
Quantum
Mania.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the Fantastic Four symbol, but
yes,
we'd seen that when the last announcements got made of all the stuff.
Yes,
but
and no
hasn't
date
been
for...
forgotten though.
No,
absolutely not.
I wonder how what are they going to do with Black Panther? Because that's my that's the
100%.
Most interesting one. I'm like,
absolutely.
What are they going to do?
Yeah,
I reckon they'll all be Black Panther and just all have a suit and just.
That's not the point of Black Panther.
Yeah.
That's not the point of Black Panther.
Yeah, that's the point
the
of
king
Black
lives
Panthers.
On in all of them, you know. Like,
yeah, I just want to see what they do.
Yeah, I don't know. Because it's not a good choice.
Part of me is like that you just quietly retired it. They exist and you can't... I know they're going to do something, but I don't know.
I know it's comic books, but especially with what they did in the movie to make him so poignant that he's got the last flower.
Mm.
Like, oh, we found another flower.
Yeah.
Like,
it's hard, isn't
it?
Yeah.
It's a bit cringy, but look, they haven't taken too many bad steps yet, so besides...
I think even if this one you're like, eh, you're like, what are they going to do?
Yeah, that's right.
It's a no-win stitch.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll put up with
they can't recast.
No.
The general public would not
no.
go for that.
Yeah, Michael B. Jordan. Just put him.
He was in there as somebody
yes.
else.
That's it. If anything, you
no, like
bring
Killmonger. A redemption sort of
he
style.
Dead.
He dead.
Yeah.
No one's ever dead.
Yeah,
if anything,
no one's ever
you
dead.
Just bring in Robert Downey Jr.'s character from Tropic Thunder. Now he's dead.
Yeah.
What I would like to see, probably, is if... Except for that, they're throwing the name around for... Bucky the White Wolf stuff. We'd bring the proper White Wolf in and let him sort of take over until Shuri's ready or whatever. He's like the uncle of Black Panther.
Was it White Tiger?
No. White Tiger's different.
Oh, they're different?
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Cool.
White Wolf's the... They're the, like, Wakanda police.
Oh!
And they look like Black Panthers, but they're white outfits sort of thing.
Oh, okay. I didn't know about
like,
them.
Yeah. And it's like his uncle's the head. But he's dodgy and stuff, you know?
Oh, okay.
Because Shuri, I just don't... Oh, I just don't know. Oh, I don't know.
What, too young, maybe?
Just not even too young, but her character, the little we've seen of her, it doesn't...
Enough.
Yeah,
doesn't...
She more like Oracle.
Yeah.
Yes.
And just... Oracle slash Tony for him.
100%. So, where if you had an intermediary where she's eventually got to realise she has to be the Black Panther or something like that, I'd be okay with. But I'm not sure. Out of the gate, I just don't think it's ready. But who knows what they're going to do.
Yeah. Very intriguing circumstances.
Yeah.
Yeah, so footage of Eternals. Like
not much.
Teaser. You didn't see anything.
I'd like to see a bit more.
It's like
them in civilian clothes.
Yeah.
It's not very exciting.
I mean, We can do something.
No. We saw nothing.
Yes. I
seen more on the toys. Yeah.
I like
Jolie
with the sword pose. Is that with it?
Yeah,
it's
Angelina
Jolie. I like her with the pose. That's it.
I'm more intrigued than anything. I'll finally learn how to pronounce Icarus or Icarus or however.
Oh, yeah. What did they say?
I don't know, but later on in the movie, they'll
Icarus,
say,
right?
Is it Icarus?
That's
Icarus.
What I always said.
I would love for them to never mention it just to piss you off.
But like, what's the main guy's name?
Dylan. Dylan don't like that. We're not going to mention it.
Unless it's like a different pronunciation. It's Icarus.
Because Icarus comes from something else, right?
Yeah, it's like a Greek.
Okay, Cecil.
Yeah, yeah, but it's spelled with a K. I don't know. Yeah. That doesn't change anything.
Yeah,
but
that's copyright.
Yeah, so they can copyright
that.
Yeah.
We can own that.
It's they changed the C to a K and they changed the U to an I at the end. And...
Yeah. Because it's a copyright.
Work for corn.
Yeah.
That's why they can't copyright Hercules. Because it exists.
Oh, yes, that's
Thor.
True.
Yeah.
Again, the image of Thor and Hercules, they can copyright, but not the name.
That was just a bit weird. Why did they even put it out?
To remind people that they still exist.
Yeah, did it need to come out?
I guess it's something new that we haven't seen before.
Black Widow's coming in like a month.
They want
IP.
IP.
You mean the Eternals footage?
Huh?
Eternals footage?
Just the whole thing.
Oh,
I didn't really understand the point.
Mm. I honestly just saw it as a bit of a media spike. You've got a month and a half before... month and a half before Black Widow comes out. There's no Marvel TV shows on right now.
Yeah.
And they're good at doing that. They're good at dropping... They're normally really good at dropping things like that just after Warner Brothers have dropped something.
Yeah, yeah.
So this one, I guess, is more of a filler as of what we've got. 4 weeks now until Loki?
Yeah.
Less?
Yeah.
Yeah, about 4 weeks now.
Yeah,
so
you didn't get enough to make it... You're like, what was the... what's the point?
Yeah.
Mm. But yeah, you're right. Just get it out in the...
And we're talking about
consciousness, yeah.
Mm. Yeah. You know, the
get
major
the,
media
get the,
platforms...
Get the Twitter mentions up or whatever.
Yeah. Engagement.
Yes. Yeah, yes. What else we got, Dylan?
Everybody watched Jupiter's Legacy?
Yeah, I saw
it.
Alrighty.
It was alright.
I didn't like it.
You thought it was animated?
Well, I'd never watched a trailer, so...
Ah.
And then the screenshot for, they chose for the trailer or something. I think it was an actual panel of a comic book.
How far into the episode did it take you to realize it wasn't?
I didn't watch it.
Oh, okay.
I seen the trailer. Finally.
So you still think it's animated?
Browsing through Netflix, it's like,
oh, so you haven't watched
it.
So
it still could be animated.
You didn't watch the first episode.
No, and I got confused. It's like, wait a minute, isn't this supposed to be animated? It's like, why is it?
I will say they made it pretty on the cheap. Because Dead Set...
Oh, yeah.
Josh DeMille's your only name, so to speak, and he's not good, the better him would have been good. And then nobody else is they're all nobodies, right?
Leslie Bibbs.
And that's... Right. What is she in besides Iron Man?
She's in Iron Man
for 3 seconds.
Yeah.
I can't name, but I've seen her in other stuff.
She's a, she's a notch in Iron Man too. You know, she's not really...
No, but she's got lots of other stuff. I just can't tell you off the top of my head.
Yeah, yeah.
But I've seen her in other stuff. Anyway, whatever. But yeah, I didn't like it.
I thought it was okay. I didn't mind it. But I just, it was alright.
Meh.
Yeah.
Right. I started it and I'm like 20 seconds in, I just his head, and I'm like, I'm not going to like this. And then there's moments, and there was moments like, okay, it's okay. And then the fight scenes were, I don't even know if that was CW level.
I stand there better than CW.
Except for Superman and Lois.
More recent CW, no. Mm. Like, that's...
Superman and Lois.
And I only watched one or two episodes of that.
Knocks it out of park.
See, the other thing, though, it's a fight in broad daylight.
That's difficult to do.
All the CW, usually the big fights, they hide in the darkness. Because you hide stuff.
Yeah. And look, if it brings a few more people to watch some superhero stuff, then I'm all for it. But it does step on a lot of the same old superhero tropes that... I guess I've seen played out a lot of times. So, I don't know, being Mark Miller... He might pull something out. I've only watched one episode, and I know it's all there, but he might pull something out a little bit more different. But I think this is one of his pretty grounded series.
Yes, I'm pretty sure.
I don't know. I probably won't go back to it. If anything, I think we're talking about the other week, I'd rather go back and watch the rest of Umbrella Academy before I go back and watch of this, because I know that that's gone along okay. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to race to finish this. I'll probably go back and watch Invincible again before I'd watch it.
Well, I think it's bad timing, because it's one thing that makes it a little different. It's the family stuff, but we've just had that amazingly in Invincible.
And you have that,
which
now,
obviously not their fault. But
obviously you have that now.
Yeah, two better.
Just normal Superman stuff as well.
Yeah, yeah.
So you've seen it everywhere. Because
when the book came out, like, you didn't get much.
Yeah, it was novel, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was like, oh, I got my dad's Superman. How do I live up to that? Like, that was the whole
purpose of the book. What, like a decade ago?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It was like one of the real early Miller World books.
And the old people makeup's not great.
No. The whole thing's made so cheap, I tell you.
As I said, it's got some, like, that bit with in the first episode with Brainwave on the beach and stuff.
Yeah,
like,
that's cool.
There's some cool tropes here, but it just...
He was the most interesting character,
yeah,
Brainwave.
Yes, yes.
That's the one you were
for
like,
a lot
oh.
of different reasons,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Especially at that dinner table, it got creepy.
Yeah.
They spend all the money on Utopian's suit. Did you see the detail on that suit?
Yeah, you're like, what is all this?
Yeah, with the filigree and
stuff.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Calm down.
And like constellation-looking stuff.
Yeah.
On there. Like, it looks cool, but it's a bit, I don't know, like...
You spend less money and got a better actor.
But like when the...
It's not good.
At the end, without spoiling stuff, when Black Star comes in,
yeah.
and you're like, ooh,
yeah.
okay.
Yeah, even
what's
then,
going
I was like,
on?
Okay.
Because like, I was only going to watch one episode, but I was like, oh, I had to play episode two.
I
and I still
know,
didn't
like,
get any more answers. So.
Yeah, I was just like, after that, I'm like,
yeah.
I had time to watch it. I'm like, I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm not going to watch it anymore. I'm like, I'll try an episode a week. I'll try for my homework.
Oh, you don't have to watch it for your homework.
I know. I'll try a second episode, and if it's still not good.
Second episode was not great. Alright. A lot of flashback, I think, in the second
episode.
Yeah,
kind of lost me.
Because there was a lot of flashbacks in the first one.
There's a few. But
it was half.
The dad?
Yeah,
his dad?
Yeah,
was that
the
first one?
The stock market
sure.
crash of 29.
Okay, yeah,
that's where that was happening.
Yeah, yeah. I couldn't remember if that was in the first
one. And then, like, dad jumps off and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
I don't think he had his powers then.
No.
No. Oh,
but,
he's just like.
So, but I think
dad.
I don't know because I haven't read
it. Dad now.
They're mentioning like the stock market's crashing, so I don't know. I got some theories on it, honestly, but I don't really care too much.
No, that's the hard part. Yeah, if they'd gone a little bit harder with the cast, the story's not bad, but I just you haven't given me enough to care.
Yeah,
I want to just look up what happens in the book and then
to see
if I want to continue. Interesting. On yeah,
and the whole. I guess it might be a personal thing, but the whole superheroes don't kill the bait thing. I don't know, it's tied to that.
Oh, but I don't know.
I know, it could have been done better.
That's one of my favourite bits of this thing, how he's so stuck in his way and fuddy duddy and that the world has moved on.
If he was a better actor, maybe.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. But I like that part. I think that's because otherwise, I think superheroes shouldn't kill.
No.
Otherwise, who would they to kill?
No, generally.
Do you know what I mean? Like,
I agree with that.
Yeah.
But.
You don't think they should kill?
If someone better delivering the lines?
Yeah.
Him just.
Yeah, he's terrible.
He's whiny.
He's always been terrible.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
No.
So yeah, I never. I wasn't a fan of the show.
Yeah,
that hurts it too because he is such a vocal main character. But
kind of the mind of like there are certain situations where it's like there's nothing else you can do.
Yeah, but they're not actually because they're not. Depends on what the situation and how
and the
employed
story?
They are by
yeah.
the government. Who are they? You can't have just because they got the power. That's the worst thing. Why do they? Just because they're strong enough to be judge, jury, executioner? I'm not okay
with
that.
It's more like you know, like in Infinity War, where Thanos is about to snap half the galaxy away. Thor,
yeah,
killing. That's where I think.
Yes, extenuating circumstances.
Yes, extremely. Like there is no
and
other
that's
way.
That's what I saw at the end of this.
Yes,
where I'm
yes.
like, I'm with the young
dude.
Of course. In that regard, because it was extenuating circumstances. And then, but the thing that annoyed me with that was we would have found a way. Well. You didn't find a way, dude.
Yes.
If you're going to find a way, you would have found the way because you're Mr. Utopia or whatever. Like, you didn't. He did.
Yeah.
But does that also show that the Utopia is holding back? Because he could kill all these people.
Yeah, he's holding back,
for sure.
So, yeah, see.
Because my weird thing was, like, how did he beat him last time? Because it felt like Utopian beat Black Star or whatever his name was last
and
time.
Maybe,
and, knocked him up.
And the way he was looking at the TV, it took a lot out of him.
Yeah.
And it was probably one of the biggest fights of his life. But, yeah, it.
Yeah,
I
don't
know.
Because that's the drama, though, of the...
Yes.
Because, like, even Infinity War, Thor ain't really down with it. You know, he struggles with what he did, even though it was
the
right thing.
100%.
Where they've established Thor, I think he would have just straight up killed him.
Of course.
He has no qualms about killing things.
100%. That was one of my problems with Infinity. Like, he'd be like, done. I've killed 1,000 trolls.
Yeah, that's like in the beginning of the first movie. He's killing so many frost giants.
Yeah. Gleefully.
Gleefully.
It's crazy.
Yeah. I think it's more just a personal thing, like just seeing all the people complain about Man of Steel for the same reasons.
Yeah.
It's kind of the same thing.
But yeah.
Of like, oh, he could have found another way. He could have gone into space, but I've just heard it before.
Yeah. So. Comes back to Dylan's Superman butthurt.
He's Superman. He lives on a farm.
Yeah, I'm of the mind that Superman should never kill.
I was okay with it.
Yeah, but in the thing, I'm like, okay.
Now, it wasn't done good enough in Man of Steel for my
life. I reckon it could have been done better.
Yeah. Yeah. I didn't believe that was his only.
And I don't think that should have been in the first movie.
I can handle him killing, but.
Not in the first movie.
Yeah. And the reasons for them doing it, like Henry Cavill said in an interview, he's like, they wanted him to learn not to kill, not just, oh, his dad taught him not to kill.
Yeah, okay.
Like, he did it, and he's like, you know, I don't ever want to do that again.
That's fair enough.
See, I would like that lesson to be more of, it was like not an accident, but like, he wasn't quite intentionally, like, yeah, no doubt it was purposeful. Yeah.
Yes.
I would more like, it's just a fight, he's hit too hard, and the guy's, and then you learn the lesson, oh man, I gotta be more careful, I look at the power, I can take a life, I don't, you know? I think that's a way more interesting lesson than just, snap his neck, I never do that again. Well, why wouldn't you? Because surely Superman's gonna face worse situations even, because this just didn't feel, he's already got him on his knees and just, oh no.
It was not executed the best in terms of the context.
Yeah, I could have Superman kill Zod, but it wasn't good enough.
Oh, he's learning his lesson now. He got sacked on his birthday.
Yeah, God! It was on his birthday they announced new Superman movie.
That was at the bottom of the...
Yeah.
Pretty sad.
What's that?
Come to the light side, Henry. Come and see you.
I'm fingers crossed for him to go there.
What would you have in players?
Herc?
Well...
Hercules?
Yeah.
Nah, not Hercules. He's not dumb enough.
Yeah. Like not someone, fun I think enough. Someone who mentioned Captain
John.
Britain?
John, I think.
Yeah,
can chat
Captain
today.
Britain. For
oh
sure.
Yeah,
Captain
he's so
Britain.
Much better. Because he's also because Captain Britain's like noble, like you know, rich.
Yeah.
So, like I think he'd pull that off.
Oh, cool.
Really good too.
I don't
yeah,
really know much about him.
Yeah, because he's their rich family, the Braddocks and stuff. You know. Like,
oh
yeah,
yeah. Okay.
You know, I think Henry Cavill.
Captain Britain.
Yeah.
100%.
Yes.
Where Herc, he's not. Yeah, he's not dumb enough
yeah.
for Herc.
No,
I don't feel.
Yeah, Marvel Herc, he's dumb.
Yeah,
he's dumb
that's what I love about him. All he wants to do is fight. Other F word than drink. Right?
Yep.
And that's what he's the best at.
I'm actually
at.
Trying to think who would be a good Herc. It's hard because...
It is hard.
Yeah.
He is such a...
Who played Zeus in Wonder Woman 84? Was it Zeus?
Zeus wasn't in that.
No, not Zeus.
Ares?
Max
Lord? Oh, you mean the main villain in Wonder Woman?
Max Lord?
No, I'm thinking Butcher. Oh, no.
What?
Carl Urban.
Oh, Carl Urban.
Yeah, Carl Urban. I'm thinking Carl Urban.
Oh, Executioner?
Oh, yeah. Executioner.
Yeah, but he's already in a Marvel movie.
Yeah.
You know when three of them, tell the story of the... in 84, the backstory of how they drove...
Talking about
Justice
League?
84, no, I'm thinking Justice League.
Oh,
Justice
the guy
League.
Played Zeus in that.
Yes.
Ah,
yes.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yes. Gotcha.
Sorry. I think he was...
That was a roller coaster.
I think he's just... Just there to be a body.
Yeah,
doing moves.
It's Colossus.
Yeah.
He's in X2.
But
he looks good.
He's a bodybuilder.
That's what you're after, right? For an X.
No. Herc's got to have personality.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
why
it's so hard.
You got to, charming and likable.
I think you'd have to go someone who don't look the part quite yet. You know, he's got the height and maybe a bit of a fatty.
Like
the
Chris Pratt
thing. Yes, that's exactly what you need.
Jason Segel.
Ooh.
If you could bulk up Jason Segel.
Yes.
That could work.
The other thing is, he's already been in Marvel, but he played Volstagg in Thor.
Yes.
He would have been a great guy.
Oh, because he was also Punisher.
He's Punisher.
He was excellent. Ray Stevens.
Yeah, he was great.
Excellent.
But Chris Pratt is exactly what you need. A more comedic guy, maybe. Yeah. But he's got the body's there. He just needs to be shaped.
Granite.
Yeah.
Chris Pratt became... He lost some weight.
Yeah.
They've got the money to... Hire personal trainers and dietitians.
That's your job. That's what you're getting paid to do.
Oh,
Turtles.
Yeah.
Enough said.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
I don't like him.
He's great.
He's a hypocrite.
Next.
We also watched Bad Batch.
Yeah.
Yeah, I watched the first episode.
Did you watch that, Dave?
Halfway through.
What did you watch? You're halfway through. It's like 20 minutes.
No, it's an hour.
First episode's an
hour.
Did go for a while. It was
all
right. Looks amazing.
Yeah, first one. I haven't seen
17 minutes, wasn't it? It said on the
no,
thing.
No,
no,
an
no,
hour
or
something.
Maybe just felt that long.
Yeah.
No, it was like an hour 10. Really.
Okay.
I haven't seen a lot of the Clone Wars series. I've seen episodes here and there, but not like
I'm not a fan.
Yeah, me neither.
But
I laughed when you sent in a chat about the voiceover because that's what I did. I'm laying there watching it when it's
in the War of the Republic.
Yeah. Enough of this.
The Clone Wars. Like, that kind of voiceover is cool when it fits, but I don't think it fits here.
No, because it's sort of over. Mm. Or is that, I hope it was just the first. Yeah. I don't know. Well, anyone watch episode 2?
Didn't come back again.
No.
Yeah, it was just in the first one?
There was like an intro that I skipped for episode 2, so I don't know.
Because if it's just in the first one, I can handle it, because it's such a nod to the Clone Wars, because it's such a sequel.
That's probably just a recap of the first.
Yeah, one. It is my, just, that's my problem with Clone Wars as well.
Yes.
But,
voiceover.
Yeah. Every episode starts like that, right?
Yes, every episode. With that narration. Every episode.
Yeah.
News every episode, you're like, ugh. Yeah. I get what you're doing, like, movie tone news, you yeah. know? Like,
but like, you know, Captain America cartoon. Perfect. Star Wars, I don't know.
Yeah, it was the voice. It was.
He's not good enough. Nah. I think, that narrator. It just doesn't. It doesn't sound.
People hate us because they love Clone Wars.
Yes.
Oh, not for me.
Well, speaking of voice, I love the fact that there's one guy doing all 5 voices.
Yes,
that's excellent.
He's talented.
He's Man, talented.
Because they sound so different, but yes. so the same at the same time. Yeah. I don't know how you do that.
Voice actors, man, they're great.
Yeah.
They ain't enough respect.
He's real voice actor.
Yeah.
Not someone who just reads
not
the line.
Not famous person.
As themselves. Yeah. Yes.
Excellent.
Well, if we're going to speak about voice actors, though. What was the deal with Kanan's voice?
I don't know.
They got Freddie Prinze Jr.
Yeah.
to voice him again.
I
he
know.
Voiced
Did he?
The character in Rebels.
Yeah.
But this is 20 years before
him. He's like 12 and he sounds like a grown man.
Yeah.
And I'm like, whoa.
He's meant to be like 12, yeah.
He's a Padawan.
Yeah, it was. It did not match.
No.
Whatsoever.
I'm like, what did he even try? Because it didn't even sound like Kanan, right? Like, I didn't think it sounded like his Kanan voice. Just like sound like a man.
Why don't you just A, get a kid to do it, or B, just pitch him up?
Yeah.
Like I've seen people do it on YouTube already.
For
just
sure,
pitch up
sure.
the voice.
Yeah.
Sounds better.
It's what we do for in post for the joke.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
down
reverse.
But it was good. I dug it.
Yeah. It was interesting.
So she's a force sensitive clone, but looks like.
Oh, she's just. I think my theory was. During halfway through the episode, she's just like them, right?
Yeah, she's a clone.
Yeah.
Genetically enhanced.
Yeah, she's a female clone of the Boba Fett.
You know, like, their thing is that they're defects, right?
I thought they were... Didn't they say they were...
Specifically, one guy got hit.
Yeah, he's not one of them.
Yeah, he's not one of them.
She is the fifth. See, that's where he gave it away, when she, the Kimonian, was like, to Tarkin, all 5 of the clones are still here. She's the fifth.
Yeah.
Because the other guy wasn't one of them, right? Yeah.
He's Robocop.
Yeah.
No, but I thought they were specifically altered to be more...
Yes, that's it.
Like a sharpshooter or a tactician.
I thought they all had like a defect first.
No, that confused me because...
I thought they were defects.
I think they're being called defective.
Yeah.
But I think they were called defective, but they've been specifically made to be better fighters or better tactician or whatever.
So they've been genetically kind of altered.
Yeah.
And that, you know, that leads to...
Because I just assume when they're, like, defective, and then the big one, for instance, you train him differently to make him more brute, is what I thought. Mm. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean, but I think it was... He was perfectly... purposely made bigger and just a brute.
At the cost of his intelligence?
Because I just... Yeah, like I was like, her defect was she... X chromosome or whatever. That's one nice way of saying it.
No, I think they just made her to be like an apprentice. Like, that's what they were using her for. But I think she's force sensitive. But
I don't think so.
Really?
I think she's like a taskmaster deal. She sees them do it and she can do it.
Yeah.
She just picks up the gun, boom. Shot a blaster.
And it's like the last shot of her looking at them doing the.
Yeah, I think it's like that.
There was this shot of Hunter giving a hand signal and she copies it.
Yeah. She was,
exactly.
Yeah, right. I just thought she was following him because
she looks
she's
up
like,
to him.
I saw that bit too, but there could be both.
Because I hope she's not force sensitive. Please.
Yeah, no, I get you.
I don't need...
I just hope if she is, they find that kid with the mop. That'd be awesome.
I would like a Star Wars show with... No Jedi.
Yeah, well, there has to be no Jedi in this time, except for killing the last couple.
Yes.
Then killing off some remnants, and then no Jedi.
Because it's like Mando season 1 was Jedi-less, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then season 2, it's got like two.
Especially this, the whole point is they just killed them all.
Nah, they're going to have a Jedi Academy with all the kids from that
and that's
planet
done.
With the horses.
If she starts to be like Force sensitive, it'd be like off.
There's already too many Jedi running around. Oh,
too many. I could handle Obi-Wan hiding out in the desert.
Yeah.
And that's probably about it.
Yeah.
To be honest, I didn't need any more.
And Yoda? I like Kanan.
Huh?
Yoda?
Oh, Yoda.
Yeah, fine.
And the thing with Kanan was he was still a Padawan.
Yes, yes.
When he got away, so yeah. His training wasn't completed.
Yeah, he's run off and he's on hide, and I get that. That's cool.
And yeah, like in Rebels, he uses a blaster a lot too because his training's not complete yet.
Sure.
But then you've got Ahsoka is just chilling somewhere and.
Don't get me started.
Don't get me started on that.
It's true. She should be dead.
I'm not going to argue. Yes. But...
I guess she's a fan favorite, but that doesn't mean she shouldn't be dead. It makes no story sense for her to be alive.
It takes away from.
Makes Darth Vader less of a.
Yeah. It takes away from Luke. It takes away from Vader. It takes away from Order 66.
Yeah.
In general, that's meant to be. They're all gone.
Yeah. Wipe her out.
Yes.
Anyway.
People love it too much. Right. I'll watch more. I'll watch more.
Mm. Yeah, I'll try.
Been saying that it's Rosario Dawson. Someone came up with
it. Yeah, I'm not complaining about Rosario Dawson.
Yeah, she makes it.
Yeah, and the guns and the armor, like getting better looks at it. It's all from Republic Commander.
Yeah.
So they're teasing me.
Yeah.
Like, are we going to see the team from the game? I don't know. Yeah. No. They were in an episode of Clone Wars though, like a little cameo. I don't know. I'm trying not to get my hopes up.
Yes.
The Bad Batch or from the game?
There's a squad from Republic Commander. You play as the leader of that squad, and that squad showed up in an episode of the Clone Wars.
Right.
That was right after. The whole Disney, all this stuff doesn't count anymore. So lots of people are like, oh, is Republic Commando still canon? And yeah, it is.
No, technically, if it's not in a movie, it's not canon.
No, the comics are canon.
I'm talking about before Disney.
Yes,
beforehand, yes.
Oh, yeah. If it's not moving pictures, essentially.
Yeah.
It just happened in MCU. I read this week that Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is not anything... There's a shock.
I think they gave up on that after
second season was still good.
Whenever Kevin Feige stopped having to report to Marvel and he just reported straight to Disney, that's when it was like, you're done. We're not talking to you anymore. And that's when the Inhumans fiasco.
Yes.
When now Kevin's like, I'm not making Inhumans. Give it to them. They can have that rubbish. And then they made a mess of it. Forever.
It's terrible. I like Black Bolt.
That was great. And I'll get that dude. That's a hard job as an actor to pull off that doesn't talk.
Yeah.
And he was not a good enough actor to do it, I don't feel.
No.
Crystal was good in it, but she was the best bit of the show.
With Republic Commando, they had a sequel planned,
mm-hmm.
and it was going to be Imperial Commando. So post 66 and Killing Jedi and that kind of thing. And I think they scrapped that, but they did some novels on it.
Uh-huh.
Thankfully, that squad stayed... Imperial. They didn't magically take out their chips and become good like all the other ones that people like. They stayed evil.
Yeah. You got it.
Yeah.
I'll watch more.
Good. I did like it.
Mm. You know, I liked it more than Jubba's Legacy.
Yes, I'll give you that.
Yeah, I agree.
And adding to like sort of this texture in the animation now.
Ah,
yes!
As opposed to...
And it is animated, Dave, just so...
Yeah.
I thought this one was live action.
Oh, really? I thought I was Sylvester Stallone.
Yes.
Yeah, no, the texture. What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Sylvester Stallone.
He's right.
Yeah, like the texture in the face. Like, it's not just flat. It's just...
Yeah.
Like, you see little pastel.
Oh, that's...
Like,
the background. Like, that first waterfall shot. And then they were at...
Yeah, that whole battle, like, when 66 comes down, like, you're like, oh my god, this looks amazing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They're not trying to give it this realistic texture. Instead, it's like brush strokes and stuff.
Yeah.
Great.
I'm just worried it might get a bit too artistic at one point. Mm. I was like,
Works for Samurai Jack.
Mm.
Are we done with Bad Batch?
I think so.
Yep.
Alrighty. Yeah. Go on to our first film flashback.
Film
of the week. Flashback segment where we go back and revisit good or bad movies.
Mm.
Yeah.
Council of Reeds, film flashback.
Hair flashback. Spawn, selected by Fomi.
So good.
I've seen this, right?
Yeah, you go first, because I don't need what you have to say.
I've seen this scene in high school, and I thought it was, oh, this is dumb, but good dumb.
Yeah.
Steph had not seen it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
She doesn't know anything about Spawn.
Yeah.
She was like, oh, I never really thought about it, but I assumed he was a Marvel character, because he looks like Venom.
Okay.
And I'm like, oh, about that. I explained the whole thing. and that was the first time watching it, and it was fun, because, like...
It's not very good.
Well, you're just watching her more, it's like, her reaction more than the movie. It's like,
it is what it is. It's got a charm. You know?
Yeah, it's one of those things.
It's got a charm, but I think if you were watching that for the first time today, I don't see how you would be like, anything but this was pretty garbage. Except for the clown.
Thank you. I was waiting for the end of that sentence before I
chimed
in.
The clown is amazing.
John Leguizamo.
And is as good as anything I've still seen today, to be honest.
Yeah, he's great. Yeah. Dissenting opinion.
I found him very annoying. And Steph hated him. Steph absolutely hated him.
She's got the worst taste in stuff.
That's mean he's done his job perfectly.
Thank you, Dave. Yeah. And thank you, Dave.
He's in this proper costume.
He can't
see CGI.
If you watch the behind the scenes,
he looks great. He
has to be like this for the whole time.
Mood. Yeah.
He's like that.
Does he have, like, crazy back problems now?
I think he did have some sort of problems afterwards, because he was squatting the whole movie.
And, like, he is annoying.
That's the whole point. Have you not?
Because you want to punch him.
He stars in a movie called The Pest. That is his character. Yeah, it's terrible. Yeah. But that is where he is at his peak. And probably the line of the movie near the start where he's getting the pizza, flicking the anchovies off.
Yes. Oh, yes. Yes.
And he takes a bite and he's like, it's so good, I could kick a puppy.
They were really good lines. He did have good stuff.
They decapitated his hands. Like, hey, Wanda.
Yeah.
Like a little head.
I think my favorite scene, though, was at the start, and it's all gloomy at the top of the cathedral, and you've got these 100-year-old stone gargoyles there. And as he's walking around, you see a bird fly and hit the gargoyle, and the gargoyle moves.
Really?
Yes, please go back. Right at the start, the bird flies, and I went, did that gargoyle just move from the bird hitting it or landing on it? I went, back 15 seconds? Back 15 seconds. Yeah, dude, that's amazing.
So, I did not notice that. The CGI is super dated.
Yeah.
And yeah, like the demon or Satan or whatever is talking about, and there's no
that's how he looks in the comic book. He doesn't know. It's all telepathic.
The look of him and the mouth so big, how dumb would it have looked if his mouth moved?
Yes, very
that's
dumb.
The hard part.
Yeah. Mm.
And is some of the worst.
Oh yeah, it just looks like PlayStation.
But some of there's some awesome CGI in there as well. For the time.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good CGI for the time.
No, the chains and the suits and the.
Yeah, the way the suit comes onto him looks great.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. And his makeup, like the face, the burn stuff, still looks, I think, good.
Holds up.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, would it be better now? Yes, but not by much.
The amount of Just for Men Martin Sheen use, how black everything is on his body.
He's cashing a check.
Oh, for sure. That's what I'm saying.
He's the greatest win, though. Hey? He's like, different cashing a check, he at least put some effort in it.
Yeah.
In his win voice and everything.
Because he could be so much better.
Yeah.
If he took it a bit seriously.
But you don't need to be so much better. It's Spawn.
No.
And the chick priest.
Yeah.
Wasn't she like the stepmommy, like the OC or something at the same time?
Oh.
It was so weird because I remember seeing, I'm like, isn't she like in some...
She looked very familiar.
Yeah.
Like had a bit of Emma Stone about her or something like that.
It's just the redness.
Yeah.
But also at the end when... she goes to kick Spawn in the crutch.
Yes, yes.
I still remember that. It always makes me, when that thing comes down and clamps on her shin bone, I'm like, oh, damn, that would hurt.
Yeah.
All these other people are getting decapitated and killed, and I'm like, damn, that would hurt your shin bone.
Because you can relate. I felt that. It's fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's not good.
You know what I don't miss? Like, the early 90s movies where all the credits were essentially at the start.
Yeah,
you just have to go through all that. It's like, oh, God.
That doesn't happen anymore, does it?
Nah. It doesn't.
You don't even have no attention span.
Yeah,
most of the time you won't even get a title.
No.
Sometimes you get a title.
Yeah. You know what always bugged me in that movie? That they redesigned the Spawn logo. Spawn's got a cool logo.
Oh yeah.
Why are you changing that?
Yeah.
Like, I get you want to maybe 3D it up and make it less flat, but what are you changing that for? but how bad is Cogliostro or whatever. He's terrible.
Mm.
Terrible. He's just terrible.
So like, the acting is not top-notch in this movie.
No.
It's not meant to be a top-notch. It's a 90s action superhero movie.
It's a great movie.
It's a product of its time.
It's a video shop.
And it's one of the first. Like, it's... Hmm. But it started, and if we didn't have that, we wouldn't be where we are now, I don't reckon. Maybe Blade might help.
Yeah. Or was it, that's the thing, like, it's only like a year or two later, and you're like, man.
Oh, yeah.
The level just.
Yeah. Well, yes, there was more money spent on one than the other. Well, most of the money on Spawn went to the CGI.
I was going to say, I don't know if the money would have been spent more. They just spent wisely the second time.
All the money went into that fight with Violator and Spawn and Cogliostro in hell.
When Clown turns into Violator, that is still cool. That was cool. Yeah.
Violator looks awesome. He looks... I know it's all CGI, but it looks...
Oh, nah, it's like stop perfect stuff, bro.
Yeah, there's some shots. There are some shots of, like, a practical head, right?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, but when he's, like, full-blown Violator looking...
The dodgiest part as well has to be the motorcycle chase.
Oh, yes!
When he falls and slides and just...
I still pointed out, you know, after everything's done, they're sitting in his house or whatever, the dog runs over to Spawn, and they're like, oh, the dog! And then they get along, and the wife is just like, doesn't connect the dots or anything.
He knows my name.
The dog. Whatever.
He knows my name. I wouldn't be able to name a dog that these days.
Nah.
That's the matter. He just names all the characters after his friends.
Yes. Well, and baseball players he likes.
Yeah.
My favorite
seems money there.
One of my favorite moments is in the cemetery when
the Satanists.
Yeah, the Satanists come up, and then Clown's like, "Oh, it's God, get all the good followers.
Yeah.
We get all the." Oh, what was it? Because I don't know. Can you say?
And Clown face on the shovel.
Yes.
Excellent.
It's fun. It's fun. It's trash.
Oh,
it's trash, but it's fun.
Cheerleader scene.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm so confused.
He's
by
the
that.
Best.
Yes.
Oh God.
Great soundtrack though.
Oh yeah,
because I when we left last week, when we were watching Spawn, I'm like, I put this on Spotify, I put the soundtrack on.
Yeah,
such a great soundtrack.
It's one of the best mashups.
Yeah, that's good.
Well, collaborative efforts anyway, or mashup, but yeah, fun.
It needs to be a little more punchy, I feel though.
Yeah,
one more maybe action scene somewhere in the middle or something. Like it's a bit draggy at times. Like it's a bit.
There's a lot of in rat. What do they call it? The
alley and all that stuff. Yeah, you like pick up the pace a bit. The kid from Kindergarten Cop was in everything. I'm like, what's that kid from?
Actually,
everything.
So
everything, yes.
Do we know the daughter? What birthday was that of hers?
She's ours.
She's ours?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
Because that's what Wanda's going to tell him that night.
Okay.
Because she tells Terry, make sure he's back.
Okay.
That's what I always assume.
Okay. Good. Because I just thought.
Straight away.
Well, if she's 5 years old, because she doesn't look that, she doesn't look four or three. That means you didn't waste too much time poor Al passed.
Because I thought when I was watching it again, it's like I always assumed the end. I'll try and allude to, but I'm watching it again. I'm like, I thought.
No.
Why don't they just go there and tell me?
Yeah,
he seems to know. The kid seems to know. But
he knows it's his. Because like he goes, oh, you got your mum's eyes, like.
What's that got to do with make it his?
Yeah.
You didn't go, you got my eyes. Obviously, she got the mum's eyes.
Yeah, but he's not surprised. Like,
well, she knew it came out of her.
Yeah.
It's him or the other guy that's the problem.
It's not come out of Terry.
But yeah, he knows. He clearly knows. But yeah, it's weird that they don't actually just go there.
Do you reckon a whole lot of stuff is cut?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
I feel like, that and some kind of scene with him and his wife.
Yeah. Like, okay.
Or just addressing it.
You know, like, even if she's like, oh. Yeah. You know, he was great to me. I needed, like he'd be like, cool. And then you go and beat him up later.
Are you sure you're the mother?
Yes. That was fun.
Let's do this for every movie. Let's give it a score out of like 10 or
five.
Something like that.
10's too much.
Yeah.
Five. And then we could combine.
I feel like 5's not enough. Whatever. Let's go 5.
7.
Yeah, let's go out of 10.
7 out of 5.
That's how good it was.
But good on what? Is that, like, when you judge something like this...
Yeah, we need, like, a scale.
You know?
Am I
grading it on the quality of the film or my enjoyment of the said film?
Everything.
You just overall rating. Don't compare it to anything.
Yeah.
Nah.
I give it a 3 because...
Out of 10?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I thought we were out of 5.
Yeah, out of 5. 5 has got to be out of 3.
Yeah.
You can't say it's a 4 or 5 star movie.
You know, I thought we were going to go out of 10.
Okay, out of 10.
Okay, it'd be 6 or 7 then.
Yeah.
6
or
6.5.
6.5. Yeah. 6.5.
Because I don't think I could say it's a 7.
Good nostalgia. Mm-hmm. It was fun.
It's serviceable.
Yes.
Yeah. I really liked it. I'm going to give it 7. It's not more than 7, but I really liked it. I still like it.
Yeah, I'll give it 6.5 as well. Yeah.
Oh, dear. I'm thinking 4.
Yeah.
That's fine. 4 or 5.
Yeah.
It's probably because I didn't have a big connection to it.
100%. Yeah. Like, when...
Because they also in the cinema.
Cinema, yeah.
We had.
Yeah, we saw it in the cinema.
Like...
The cape doesn't look as good as I remember it, so...
And, like...
I thought the
only comic book movies we'd ever had really Batman and Superman.
Mm. Yeah.
At this time.
So
really?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, and then when it had this and then the soundtrack that was attached to it at the same time.
Yeah, I gave an extra point for the soundtrack.
Mm.
It's
the writing is on fire. Oh my god.
Yeah, because after that, like you had Blade come out and then X-Men.
Yeah.
Because yeah, like no context is really important.
Of course. Yeah, I totally would expect you to be
going. I'd probably give it a 5 then. Because it's like if you go back and you watch Superman the movie and you don't know anything about it, it's pretty
Yeah. It's still good. It's just slow.
Is it?
It's super slow. It's great, but it's so slow.
I can never.
But everyone says about Jaws these days too. I still slap anyone.
If you don't like Jaws, you're an idiot.
I totally agree. But
if you don't like Jaws,
people
stop watching.
Like it, but they think it's too slow. And I just you're building attention. That's the whole point. So. It is hard.
Oh no, there's not enough jump scares for people.
No, you don't like Jaws, stop watching and go away.
Yes.
Never come back.
That's true.
We'll cancel your standing order.
Okay, don't. Nin does not speak to the comic shop.
We still want money.
Yeah. Okay, just give us your money, just don't talk to us.
Yeah.
So.
Everyone gave a rating?
Around 6.5.
Yeah, I'd say 6.5, 7 would be consensus then.
Yeah.
Maybe average.
We'll
which is fair, I think.
Well, Dylan gave it like
5.
Yeah. 4.5.
Yeah.
4.5.
Yeah, okay.
6 out of 10.
Done.
It's
perfect. All right. So, Jay's is going to pick the next one.
All right. So, I was looking last night after I finished watching Spawn, because I want to try to make it something easy for us all to go watch. So, I was looking through the stream service. And I was like, Amazon. I'm pretty sure we all got Amazon since we're watching Invincible. So, I picked Howard the Duck. I haven't watched Howard the Duck in a long, long time.
I was a literal kid when I watched Howard the Duck, so I have not seen it
since. I bought the Blu-ray like a couple years ago and never watched it.
Yeah.
So I'll probably just pull that out instead of the Amazon.
So, yeah, my memories of this are pretty hazy, so we'll see.
I haven't seen it, so.
Cool.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, cool. I watched a couple of years back. Caroline in the City's in it, so it should be good.
With the little disturbing bedroom scene. That's the best bit of the movie.
You may find it disturbing, others might.
yes, Howard the Duck. The first Marvel theatrical release.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
Because it was like 86 or something.
Wow.
And then we didn't get another theatrical release really until maybe Blade? Because I don't think Punisher might have got one. Maybe Dolph Lundgren.
Punisher would have got one.
Yeah, for sure, right?
No, I don't know. I think it was like a...
No, I think Punisher would have got one. Because Dolph Lundgren was big. He was like, Dolph Lundgren.
But it was... That just reeks of a straight-to-video shop movie, right?
Mm, I don't know.
And Cap was just...
Yeah, Cap was like,
Look this
big right
Punisher
there.
Thing up later.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Because we didn't get... There was like, no Marvel movies.
Okay.
Wow.
How it is.
For that to be the first one is very interesting.
Yeah, Howard the Duck.
Weird choice as a first to go. Yeah, interesting. Cool.
It's a George Lucas joint, so when he's trying to distance himself off.
I don't know why. It's not that bad. It gets way too much hate. There's a ton of comic book movies worse than that. A ton. Some coming out in recent years, like from DC. I'd watch Howard the Duck over Suicide Squad any day of the week. I'd watch Howard the Duck over Birds of Prey. I'd watch Howard the Duck over having to sit for 4 hours of Justice League ever again in my life. What else they got? It's better than Steel from a decade later.
Wonder Woman 84.
Yeah, it's better than Wonder Woman 84. It's better than most of their movies.
I could watch a whole movie of just like...
It's better than Thor Ragnarok.
What's a guy like in 84, the pilot? What's his name again?
Steve Trevor?
Yeah, like just him, like mind blown with all like the technology and that. I could just watch a whole movie on that. That was like the only saving grace of 84 for me.
Okay, so.
You like.
Like breakdancing, trains, planes, like.
Casino Man or something.
Yeah.
Blast from the Past?
Yeah.
I like that movie.
That was a good movie.
I did like that movie.
Yeah,
great movie.
Chris
Walker is excellent. Though.
That's Brendan Fraser one.
Yeah,
I remember watching that as a kid.
That was a good movie. For what, like, especially for like just a teen movie sort of thing, like it was Jeff above.
Mm.
Alright, so yeah, How the Ducks Might Choose next week.
Yeah.
Cool.
If Brendan Fraser was younger, he could have been a good Hercules from our story.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
He so is perfect.
We were having a conversation before this podcast about Hercules from the Marvel Universe in, and we don't really feel... We heard what Henry Cavill may be
playing.
There was
rumours.
There's
yes.
rumours. Hopefully it's not.
He is not done enough.
It was on the podcast we were talking about this, wasn't
it? Was it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I don't know how long this podcast has been going for.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I'm in the same boat as Tommy.
You're in the same
boat,
thank you. Okay, I thought it might have been before. Anyway. Yeah, so
Brendan,
definitely
yeah.
Brennan, younger
yeah.
Brendan Fraser.
You guys seen George of the Jungle?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Not just
yeah.
that.
Watch
when he played in Bedazzle, when he played that giant basketball
player.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the first thing that popped into my head.
No, yeah, he is.
He would have been awesome.
Perfect.
Yeah.
That's exactly what you need.
Yeah.
Big enough dude that you believe, but
he
a bit of a dumb.
Still has the looks to pull it off.
No.
Have you seen
him?
I
haven't seen
him
recently.
Is he Doom?
Oh,
he plays the robot in Doomatron.
Yeah.
That's why he's in a suit.
I could have finished that.
Yeah.
He's put on some weight.
Okay.
What is he?
Put it nicely.
No, just the face. Though.
Yeah, no, I don't think he's aged.
He's in something else recently,
well,
too.
Yeah.
Where he was
okay.
like a,
so he's not like
guy,
a Paul Rudd or something like that?
Mm.
No, no, not at all.
That guy's ageless.
He
you
looks
can't
like
compare
he
anyone to Paul Rudd.
Brendan Fraser looks like he ate Brendan Fraser.
Okay.
You can fit two of him inside him.
He wasn't always like the most lean dude, you know?
No, but he was... It's not even like I'm fat, what do I care? He can be as fat as he wants, I don't care. Is he
yeah.
happy? But he's just, his head's just...
Bigger.
Big.
Yeah, okay.
He's got a big fat
it's
head.
Like,
and he always had a fat head.
I watched Coming to America last night.
Mm.
Eddie Murphy's not fat, but his face
yes.
is fuller.
Yes, yes,
yeah,
yes.
So
yeah.
it's just not... Yeah.
Old.
Yeah, it's
they're
just...
old.
Yeah, exactly
they're 50.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm. Coming to America, disappointing. Yeah, anything else?
That, we've reached the end of the list. Is there anything else you guys want to just...
Are you got anything else?
Well, I got a Lego.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yes! That looks really fun! Are you going to build it or are you going to leave it in the box like a sucker?
No, I'm building it, man.
Okay, good.
How much is Dylan paying for the...
the experience.
No,
yeah.
Dylan, you're welcome to come over and watch me build it. But Venom Lego.
I'll put
bust.
Up a picture for YouTube people.
We're also talking how cool it would be. You could do, like, the Rogues Gallery of Spider-Man.
Yeah.
There's, like, an Electro head and a lizard
scorpion.
Head. Scorpion
oh.
head.
Mysterio!
Mysterio.
Oh.
Yeah, Goblin, like that. You could
Mysterio, wouldn't that just be a
big fish bowl?
Ball,
yeah,
but,
yeah.
But then you could have the white pieces coming
yeah.
off and the big. Yeah,
that'd be cool.
I like the Green Goblin.
And there'd be different shades of white on the fish bowl to make it look. Yeah.
A rhino.
Chameleon would be awesome.
Also, like that without the cool bits on it.
Yeah,
essentially,
it's just white.
Just one piece.
That does look really cool.
Yes, that should be good.
You know what you do? You take a photo of it.
Because you got to like
get the negative of it and make an anti bin.
Studs on the side. That's really cool.
Yeah, it looks too hot.
Yeah, that's why they bring the give you a book.
Just the teeth are interesting pieces because they're massive compared to.
Yeah.
Those are like Bionicle pieces, I believe. Bionicle and Hero Factory.
Okay. All right.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
So. But it's like 20 centimeters tall, so it probably is like just a tiny bit bigger than that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably pretty close to scale.
Mm.
Cool.
Right.
I'll let you know what it looks like.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, they released some new ones, the Star Wars ones. It's like a Scout Trooper now.
Oh, cool.
Helmet. That looks really cool. Like, they got the
visor
bit.
Part. Because it's
it
a cool
looks
design,
great. Yeah.
Man.
And the Vader. The Vader and the Scout Trooper ones look really good.
Cool.
And there's a in that same scale... A probe droid from episode 5.
Oh.
Yeah, and it's got like a plaque with info on it.
Did you see the Mando helmet? A4 replica.
No.
Yeah. $240. Visor comes down.
Cool.
Oh,
yeah,
cool.
I've seen the Boba Fett one in places.
Yeah, this is the this is pre-order at the moment. Pretty damn cool.
And I went down to New Levo Kmart, just opened up.
Oh yeah.
They had the Razor Crest down there, Lego set. I think it was like 200.
Ooh.
Jeez.
But it looked so good.
Of course.
One of us, then I was in his mum went the other day and she told me she bought the kid Razor Crest. And I was like, can you be my mum? Like,
yeah, man, seriously. That's a big set.
Yeah.
My friend just got the Ecto one. He's got it for his missus.
Oh, the
cool. Which one?
The premium one?
The premium
one. Oh, so like the one that's not minifig scale?
Yeah.
Okay.
The proper big one.
Yeah.
If I was spending 200 on it, I'd buy that too.
Yeah.
Can't wait to see how that looks built.
Whole new list of like not approved but Lego ideas sets that are in review came out.
Yeah.
The Metroid one's in there. It's in review, so I'm fingers crossed that one gets approved. There's like a Zelda one too, and there's a couple other ones I saw in there. But I'm open for that Metroid one. I might have to buy two because
you get like if the,
there's potentially
the Zelda
like,
would get a green light before Metroid.
If they approve them, it'll be
if,
just part
if
of
if Zelda the goes Nintendo. And goes alright, you might get lucky, I reckon.
It'll be like a Nintendo line. It won't be an idea.
Yeah, I know, but...
Yeah.
They still got to do the math, though, and they're like, oh, what's Metroid? You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, does it sell enough?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And so, like, if they'd go Zelda because it's got a better, way more brand recognition, and if that sells alright... Because then that gives them a base of, like, okay, this is what... Metroid would sell 10% less or whatever, you know, they do their math.
Well, it makes sense. They've done the Mario, Zelda would be the next, and then Metroid essentially.
Yeah, down the bottom of the barrel side.
Yeah.
It's lower, but there is still a buyer
for sure.
To do a smaller run.
Just a Donkey Kong-like level, obviously.
Yes.
That would be so cool.
Should move like
at the top and just, yeah.
Jeez, that's...
Rolling down the barrel.
Build it, Dave. Make the idea, dude.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do it.
I'll do it.
Do it, Dave.
No, you won't.
It's easier than ever these days. You can just get like a program on the computer, and you can build it in there.
What didn't weren't you telling me on Lego Masters they were just making video games?
I've been watching Lego Masters.
It's a great show.
Yeah,
it's great.
I haven't watched the new season yet.
That last episode was the challenge was they get arcade machines and they've been hollowed out and there's studs inside the arcade machine
you build an
arcade game like part of the brief was you have to have the UI, you have to have a score and stuff to make it look like an arcade game.
All right.
It was an awesome episode. Oh, what on Monday, it? Monday's episode, Marvel themed episode on Monday.
Ooh. Okay,
I'm excited for that.
Yeah, I'll probably wait till Diver and just smash it. That's what I called last season. It's a great show. I like it, but I forget. I don't watch enough TV.
We went to the DC Lego exhibition that had the powerhouse three years ago.
Awesome. I went to that as well.
That was so great. Like, the full scale Batmobile.
Mm.
Oh my goodness, that was great. There's some fairly talented people out there with the Lego.
Oh man.
It's the mosaics of the covers.
The Killing Joke cover mosaic was
like
2 meters by. Oh, it was massive. Mm. That was really cool.
It's an awesome Bizarro one that I won't forget. That was great.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool.
Alright, let's go home. This stool's uncomfortable.
Time to go home.
Bye.
See ya. Like, comment, subscribe.
Subscribe. Scrub.
Subscribe.